Hey everybody, what is going on? So today let's talk about the Avengers campus coming to Disney California Adventure. So just the other day, Disney made it official. They gave us an opening date for Avengers campus. That opening date is summer 2020. So it's just around the corner. Just a few months and the Avengers campus will be open. Now, I want to clarify, the Avengers campus opening will consist of the Pym Ant-Man brewery bar eatery, the Doctor Strange magic show, basically, and the upcoming Spider-Man attraction. That is all we're getting right now with the summer 2020 opening, okay? It won't be for another year or two, probably, for that Avengers e-ticket that they announced at D23. So I want you guys to keep that in mind. Now, what do I think about this? Well, I'm not really too surprised. I've been watching a lot of Fresh Baked construction updates. Shout out to Dave. I watched a lot of that, a lot of his updates and everything in regards to the park. And from the updates that I'm seeing, it really does look like, you know, they're pretty much, I mean, the buildings are up. They're starting to add, you know, thematic elements to these buildings. It's starting to really come together. So I can't imagine it taking much longer than summer. They look like they're really moving along on this land. Now, what are my overall thoughts? I kind of wanted to give you my overall thoughts in regards to this Avengers campus because we're coming up now. It's less than a year away. We're, you know, summertime's coming up quick. What are my thoughts on this? Well, I'll be honest with you. This is not going to be Galaxy's Edge, okay, in terms of quality. So we can throw that out the window. That's not going to happen. It's not going to be Galaxy's Edge. But it's also not going to be Pixar Pier. It's also not going to be A Bug's Land. It's going to be better than that. So while I'm not super impressed so far with what they've shown us in terms of the Spider-Man attraction and just the overall area. I mean, it looks really good. It looks nice, but it's nothing spectacular, right? It's not going to blow your mind. I'm actually really excited for it though. And I'm excited for it because I think that the bigger picture here is that I think it'll be really beneficial to this park. I think this is an area that DCA really needed. You know, I mean, the Spider-Man attraction isn't going to be like all the bells and whistles of like Galaxy's Edge, but it'll be a nice, you know, like maybe D ticket for families. And DCA definitely needs more family style attractions, right? And the area that it's replacing, which is Bug's Land, didn't have a lot of family attractions. Bug's Land was really geared towards small children. So I think this is kind of an upgrade. I think this is an area that the whole family can enjoy. So in terms of the Avengers campus, in relation to the entire park of California Adventure, I think it's a huge win. It's a huge asset. It's a huge addition. To this park. I think it'll really contribute a lot to the overall roster of attractions and just things to do at this park. So I think it's definitely a win for DCA. But like I said, it's nothing. You're not going to walk into Avengers Campus and be blown away. This isn't going to be Pandora. This isn't going to be Batu. It's not that kind of land. And really, to be honest with you, as much as I love the MCU, as much as I love Marvel, it's a lot harder to craft an immersive land like a Pandora or like a Batu based on the Marvel properties. And reason being is when it comes to the MCU, it's the superheroes. It's Iron Man, Ant-Man, Thor. You know, the superheroes are the star of the show. And they largely live in our world. A lot of the stuff with the Avengers happens like in New York. Tony Stark lives in Malibu. It happens in very real world kind of environments. There are some exceptions, I know, with Wakanda and things like that, but for the most part, Marvel takes place in our world, and it's basically the superheroes that are the special element of that whole dynamic, right? Whereas in like Star Wars, you have like these fantastic, crazy different planets. It's a different galaxy. It's completely foreign and alien to us. And same with Pandora. So you can really build an immersive land and be transported to something completely different With Marvel, it's a lot harder to do that, especially when you have to play within the California theme. So again, I'm not expecting this campus to be this really immersive thing like Batuu or Pandora. I really don't think it will be. Okay, and I don't think it's setting out to be that anyway. But like I said, in the overall scheme of things and in the relation to the park, I think it's a great asset to DCA. I think this is something that DCA needs greatly. I think it'll help the park a lot. And in 2 or 3 years, when we get that big Avengers E ticket, it'll really flesh out DCA in regards, you know, and make it a really, you know, solid park, a solid secondary park to Disneyland. So overall, I'm super excited for this. I think it's a great addition, but what do you guys think about Avengers Campus opening officially summer 2020? What are your thoughts? What are your thoughts on the land? What are your thoughts on the Spider-Man attraction coming? What are your feelings on all of it? Thank you all so, so much for watching. And as always, have a marvelous day.